It is a good thing to give thanks unto the Lord and to bless his holy name. Good morning, my brothers and sisters throughout the Leeward Island District and beyond. This week, sharing with you is the Anguilla Circuit. My name is Vincia Celestine, a minister serving in that circuit. Our theme for this week is a prayer for strength to do God's work. That's our general theme, a prayer for strength to do God's work. And for today, our theme is a prayer for strength to overcome evil with good. A prayer for strength to overcome evil with good. Let us now listen to that song, "You're My Strength When I Am Weak." Let us pray. Father God, we praise you for your love and faithfulness towards your children. We praise you for being a God who is perfect, holy, and trustworthy. A God who is bigger than all powers of evil. All evil we experience here on earth. We ask you, O God, that you give us eyes to see when evil is before us. Hearts to hate evil and the desire to flee from its presence. We ask that you would not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from evil and draw us closer to yourself. We ask these things in Christ's name. Amen. Our scripture reading for today is taken from Romans chapter 12, verses 17 to 21. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God. For it is written, "Vengeance is mine, I will repay," says the Lord. No, if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their heads. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. Let us pray. Guide us, O God, by your word and spirit, that in your light we may see light, in your truth find wisdom, and in your will discover your peace, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. There is, we can say, so much evil and unkindness in our world today. So often we hear that. And so it is tempting to push back when someone pushes you. It is tempting when someone hurts you to hurt them back. Sometimes our emotions get the better of us. And that is exactly what we do. We strike back. Or if we have been hurt time and time again, we might try playing the bully and hurting others before they get a chance to hurt us. Scripture commands us to not to be overcome by evil, but to overcome evil with good. In our world, where no one is supposed to get the better of you and where we always are supposed to have the last word, we read these words from Scripture. If your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. Too many of us as believers are failing to experience consistent victory over our anger, fear, self-centeredness, and our pain. When somebody wrongs us, our first instinct is to wrong them back. If you are driving, for example, down the road during the night, and the person coming the opposite direction shines their bright headlights on you, what's your initial reaction? For most of us, the first thing that we do is to shine your light back at that person. And we say we give him or her a taste of their own medicine. In our worldly way of thinking, we get this idea that if it's done to us, then it automatically allows us to retaliate, and it comes so natural. Those of you who have kids living with you, many times you have heard, "Why did you hit your sister?" And the response when that person complains is that she hit me first, or he hit me first. And that supposedly makes things right. Well, for Paul, if you want to follow Christ, then it doesn't make it right. Paul would say to you, to us today, rise above that tit-for-tat philosophy. Just because someone does something to you doesn't mean you get to do it to them. Don't repay evil for evil, and don't try to get even. I trust that someone is listening very attentively, especially within our context of our church as we prepare or as we conduct our different meetings. So often we hear of the grievances and persons' willingness to retaliate. You see, we overcome evil in this world not by becoming evil ourselves, but by overcoming evil with good. Our purpose as Christians is not that we get even with everybody, but that people see Christ living in us. People see Christ working in us to the point that they turn to Christ. Imagine, sisters and brothers, the impact it would have if every person went out this week and gave up their right to get even with people. If someone cuts you off, imagine if you didn't song your horn and extend to them a finger wave, but instead let them in and wave and smile at them. I'm sure that you know what I'm talking about. Don't be overcome with evil, but overcome evil with good. And our example for that is Jesus Christ. Upon the cross, men spat on him, cursed at him, mocked him, and tortured and crucified him. Yet not once did he curse back. Not once did he strike back at them. Instead, he prayed for them. He loved them. And he prayed, "Father, forgive them." And he did the same for you and for me. While we were yet sinners, the scripture tells us, Christ died for us. And when we have deserved wrath, he instead has poured out blessing after blessing so that we can count our blessings and we can name them one by one. And so I encourage you throughout this week, throughout this month, and the rest of the year and the years to come, that we will seek to follow the example of Christ, that we may have that strength. We will pray daily for the strength to overcome evil with good. May God help us so to do. Let us pray. Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, even now that where there is hatred, let us spread love. Help us to love one another and overcome evil with good works. Thank you for showing us how to act. Thank you for showing us how to feel, how to forgive, how to serve, how to love. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Help us to follow his holy example and overcome evil with good. Help us to turn the other cheek on the evil that is done to us and to others. Give us the courage and knowledge to be a role model of your love and your word in all that we do. I ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and our example. Amen. And so you can join in singing that well-known hymn, Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior, forever. In Jesus, we can be victorious over evil. We can overcome evil with good. And now receive the benediction. Go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak and help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed and wonderful week.
Precious blood.